Thank you so much. And today for seniors, helping those addicted to opioids. The crisis in our country, I'll tell you what, those who are addicted will find that it also affects seniors. Now, here's a troubling statistic. Nearly a third of all Medicare patients, almost 12 million, were prescribed opioid painkillers by their physicians in 2015. Now, that same year, 2.7 million Americans, those over the age of 50, abused painkillers. Savvy Senior Editor Jim Miller is back with warning signs for families. And this is really tricky, Jim, because as you get older, you can have increased pain, arthritis, cancer, age-related things. And so a lot of older folks are on opioids. How do you know when they're on too much?
Well, Linda, like you said, taking as prescribed opioid medications in short doses is very effective for pain for seniors. But when they're taken in long-term, over long periods of time, they can become very addicted to people. So that's the problem. You know, people that take long-term opioid medications need to be tested and screened to make sure that they're not addicted for it. It's also important for people to understand, too, that being addicted to opioids isn't a character flaw or a weakness. It actually affects the chemicals in the brain. So certain people are more chemically vulnerable to become addicted to opioid medications, especially those that take them long-term.
Some of the addicts that we talked to in doing a special series said the first time they took one, they were hooked. Yeah. That's all it took.
Yeah.
It's a scary thing.
It is scary,
So what are some of the signs of addiction that we should look for in people we love?
Yeah. So some of the red flags would be like if your loved one cannot stop themselves from taking the medication, or if their tolerance for the drug continues to go up. In other words, if they need more of the medication to get the same effect, or if they continue to take the drug even without their doctor's consent. Those are three red flags to keep an eye out for.
And so you find these symptoms. Who can you turn to for help?
You know, the best thing to do is the first step is actually to make an appointment with your family physician or with the prescribing doctor. And or you can also get help through a specialist. There's a medical organizations, the American Society of Addicted Medicine and the American Academy of Addiction Psychiatry. They have websites that actually have directories on their website, so you can find a specialist in your area if you want to tap a specialist.
What kind of treatment should people expect if they get involved with this?
It depends upon the person. The treatment can vary a little bit, but the goal of treatment is to obviously stop taking the medication and avoid taking it in the future. Doctors can actually write certain medications, prescribe certain medications that can help people relieve their withdrawal symptoms and to be able to curtail or to be able to control their cravings for it. So that's the first thing. After they can get the detox and get that a little bit under control, they need counseling and therapy to be able to deal with the depression, the cravings, and to avoid the drug in the future. So it's kind of a two-fold process.
And here's part of the problem. We already know that getting those type of services for the general population is difficult.
Yeah.
How in the world do you get it for someone in an age group that really there are even fewer services available?
Yeah. That's right. There's a resource called the Substance Abuse and Mental Health Services Administration. It is it's a government organization by the National Institute of Health that provides a helpline that you can call them up and ask all kinds of questions, and they can also refer you to services in your area that can be able to help you get some help for your loved one there.
And what if you think a physician is too free with these prescriptions?
Yeah, that's right. You need to contact the state medical board, the board that licenses the doctors too, and report them. So that's an important part of the process. Most doctors, they're not doing anything. Most of them are writing prescriptions to help their patients, not knowing that they can become addicted to it or not realizing what's happening. So most of the most cases, it's not really an issue, but sometimes it can be.
All right, Jim Miller, we appreciate you so much. Now, for more information, please go to Jim's website, savvysenior.org, or we have a link for you at kfor.com for seniors.